broadcasting live 4 days a week worldwide
from the sunny beaches of Southern California.
This is ExtremeHealthRadio.com.
Well, hello there. This is Steve Hines from Hope Wellness Center in Cunha, Mexico. And I love listening to Justin and Kate because they provide such cutting-edge information. Tune in live every day to get inspired and learn about natural health. Dr. Feelgood signing off.
With all the advances in medical technology today, the key to longevity may be as simple as vitamin C. Discover the power of lipospheric vitamin C at ExtremeHealthRadio.com/vitamin C. Are you ready to feel younger and healthier? Harness the healing power of the C. Take control of your health and visit ExtremeHealthRadio.com/C, S-E-A, and use the coupon code Justin, J-U-S-T-I-N, and get 20% off. Discover the secret to eternal youth. Well, thank you, everybody, for joining us on another episode, another show, another production. Is that what you call it?
Another production. Feels like a production over here.
Sure it does.
When you can't get the soundboard right. And
that's right.
Everything else.
So we want to thank all you guys for joining us. It's going to be an awesome, awesome interview. We're really excited to have Jill Schneider on the show. We're going to be introducing her in just a moment. This is episode 316 of Extreme Health Radio. So anything that we mention on today's show, like the different websites or different books or anything like that, they're all going to be available on our show page here, episode 316, so you can check that out. And I want to let you guys know, too, that we broadcast live 4 days a week on Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday at 9 a.m. Pacific if you guys would like to join us in the live chat room and make some friends from all around the world with people who are interested in natural health. So that's always available to you guys. And if you'd like to support our show, which is something that we greatly appreciate and are so thankful for, you can always go through our link on Amazon, extremehealthradio.com/Amazon. Anytime you make a purchase, doesn't have to be health-related. That helps to support us. You can also visit our sponsors as well on our sponsorship page. Today's sponsors are SNC and Livon Labs, so make sure to check those out. And what else is going on? We just got back from a really awesome one-day little getaway, didn't we, Kate?
Yeah, we drove up yesterday about 2.5 hours north of where we live to the town of Montecito.
Montecito. We went to go see Oprah.
Yeah, right.
And Rob Lowe.
And Rob Lowe. And Cindy Crawford and a couple other people who live
up Crawford
there.
Cindy Crawford lives there, too.
But, yeah, it was a real quick trip just for the day. But, man, we did some beautiful hiking up in the hills and then jumped in the beautiful, beautiful ocean afterward to cool off. It was a great getaway.
It was amazing, amazing.
Much needed.
Much needed break. Sometimes you just need those breaks,
mm-hmm.
right? Got to get away. And Jill was just telling us before we went on the air that she's going to be going to Italy. So we'll talk to her about that and dancing on the streets of Italy.
Nice.
Got nothing against that. So when I first heard of Jill Schneider, it was through a friend of ours, a former guest on our show, Chris Wark, and he interviewed her at a cancer conference. I think it was the Annie Appleseed conference. Just a really, really inspiring story, and I think it's really important that we talk about her story with cancer and overcoming it. And so Jill joins us today from sunny Florida. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Jill, so great to have you on. This is awesome.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm really looking forward to this.
And you got to be looking forward to Italy on Thursday, don't you?
Yeah, taking off for Italy. Sicily. Particularly Sicily. I've never been to that part of Italy, so I've heard really incredible things because it's so full of, I mean, Italy in general, Europe in general, is so full of history. Mm. But this place goes over the top. And I don't know, even though I know that there's mafia still going on, I don't really think they're going to bother a 69-year-old woman with a guitar.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen.
I hope not.
Schlepping around the mountains in Italy, I really don't think I'm going to be a target in any way, shape, or form.
I agree with that.
Unless they don't like your music, that's the only thing.
That is always possible.
That's always possible.
I'll I'm going to write a song for Sicily. I know it's going to happen. I already feel it coming.
Oh. That is so cool. So you were saying before the show that you do this, you've done this for the last few years straight?
Yeah, I have. Mm-hmm. I figured out a way, first of all, to fly on points as much as possible and to stay on farms with organic, biological is what they call their organic. So as much as possible to stay on farms. And actually, farm stays are very, very popular now throughout Europe. And you just go to, you just can just Google in Farm Stay Italy or Farm Stay France. And there are even places that you could work on the farm and be able to stay and have an international experience. It's pretty amazing. Yeah.
Wow.
Wow, what a cool thing. And so you're going to go there for a few weeks? Is that what you kind of normally do?
Well, yeah, normally a few weeks. This is going to be a little short of a few weeks. Uh-huh. And basically fly in to Palermo, the major city. It's one of the major cities in Italy. And I'm going to avoid the city because I'm renting a car. And this is the first time that I've driven in Italy, in Europe, ever. Ooh. And, of course, I wanted a really good deal, so I took the manual, okay? The manual transmission, in other words. And it's been a long time. It's only been about 14 years since I drove a truck in Idaho for a few months. And before that, I'm a 60s girl, so, you know, I had a lot of Volkswagens. I had little, you know, little convertibles with standard transmission along the way. So it's like something like riding a bike and other things. You never forget how to do that stuff.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
But
that is
I'm taking my time because I also don't know my way around and I don't really speak that much Italian.
So you are an adventurer.
Oh, yeah. I'm a little wild.
Holy moly. You're speaking my language right now.
Yeah.
I love it. Yeah.
And I always go by myself because I'm never alone.
Mm. Have you been that way your whole life, been an adventurer? Because I know you went to South America and things like that.
Oh, yeah,
as well.
Yeah.
You've been
You know
really
what happens? This is me. I get a bug. I get an idea. I get excited. And I just start researching about what it is I want to do. And I'm going at such a pace that no one can keep up with me.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I love it. I love
so
it.
Cool. So I have to just go and do it.
Yeah, and go by yourself because who's going to keep up with you?
No one's going to keep up with me and no one's going to keep me, you know, like limit me in any way. I can't have that.
That is so cool. And so your journey started when you were about 29 years old. Is that kind of how things started for
you? Well, actually,
field?
The particular journey of the cancer, of the dis-ease, dis-ease, mm-hmm. That I had no idea. I actually, 2 years before, had been traveling in India and in Nepal for 3 months. And I came back and I moved into an ashram in Miami. And doing meditation and just really living a very simple life. Didn't even have a car, rode a bicycle downtown to a job that I had. And just happened to say, well, you know, a friend of mine said, you know, I just came back. I did a little examination, a pap test. I said, oh, okay, you know, what's the name of your doctor? I'll call him. I'll do it. Anyway, I did. And lo and behold, He took one test and it turned out to be a number 5, classification 5 at that time. Now these were different measurements than there are today. So, this was just, you know, he said it's conclusively malignant and then he took another test to make sure. And yes, it was conclusively malignant cervical cancer. Mm. And they wanted to schedule me for a hysterectomy or at least for some kind of, you know, exploratory surgery at that point in time.
29 and years old.
29. I don't even think I had insurance when I think back. I don't even think I thought about it. I didn't even worry about it. I was so deep in meditation that I was like, I was present, truly present with myself.
Hmm. Wow. So this happened at 29 years old, and were you following any kind of, you felt okay, right?
Well, I felt fine. I was eating probably a lot of white flour and white sugar, because even though I was a vegetarian for the last 2 years before that, You know, we in the ashram, we were even eating, you know, so we had whole wheat bagels.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, that'll make it okay.
And a lot of cheese, okay. And so I just figured, for some reason, I took it seriously, very seriously. The story goes is that basically I found out, and that night I was scheduled to perform. I'm a musician and a singer-songwriter, and I was supposed to perform on a radio show in Miami. Oh. And my music partner, Bob, comes to pick me up, and we go down to this music, to this radio station in Miami, and you know, in the car, I mentioned to him, oh, by the way, I just found out I have cancer.
Oh, my gosh.
And he was like, are you okay? Can you do this? I said, I'll do it. I'll do it. So, you know, when you're sitting in that room waiting to go on, it was like, okay, this is it. This is called the time of surrender.
Mm-hmm.
And I just put everything. I put my life, my breath, my everything in God's hands. That was it. And I said, that's it. I'm yours. Whatever you want to do with me right here, right now, it's up to you.
Wow.
And let it go. And that session, I sang three or four songs. It was like I wasn't even singing. It was so beautiful. It's probably the best. I wish I had recorded it. It was the best performance that I ever gave.
Wow. So you were fully present and you were just...
Oh, completely. I had no fear of anything.
Yeah. Why? I mean, how could you, right, at that point?
No. And, you know, I had spent a few hours thinking about it before Bob came to pick me up and after the doctor, you know, and then that whole week they're calling me, oh, got to get you into the hospital, got to, you know, get the appointment set for the hospital. And I just said, after two or three times that they called me, I said, you know something? I'm going to do this my way.
Hmm.
Please don't call me anymore. Hmm. You're going to die if you don't have the surgery and all this kind of stuff. And the doctor was freaked out. He had actually, when I told him in his office that I was just going to make some changes in my life and I'd be okay, he just looked at me like,
like you're crazy.
Oh my God.
I bet.
Whoa, she is crazy.
Wow.
And I am. I'm crazy for life. Hmm. I'm crazy for God. I'm crazy for this love that we have inside of ourselves. That's what I'm crazy about. And I'll do everything in my power to live with that energy that is sustaining this breath.
That's amazing. And so back then you were 29 and the doctor is probably standing in the room. He's older, towering over you and doing that whole intimidation thing. And so were you very nervous when you told him that? I'm sure you were, right?
A little bit. Heart was beating a little faster, and then, but there was that other, you know, I'm a rebel, okay? You know, child of the 60s, and nobody's going to tell me what to do.
I love it.
When you were telling this doctor, basically, or these doctors, that you were going to do it your own way, did you have already a plan formed in your mind, or were you like, I'm just going to go out and figure this out, or did you kind of know the direction which you were going to go?
I didn't know the exact direction, but I had a feeling that I would be guided through the whole process because my whole life I'd been guided through every process. So why was this day different than any other?
Right, yeah, right.
That's true. So looking back on it, on the whole experience, what do you think, gaining some perspective, what do you think with the reason for your diagnosis was? Can you pinpoint anything?
Well, you know, it could have been a few things, okay? I could have gotten a parasite when I was in India because I was really sick. That was a rough trip. I traveled third-class trains throughout northern India and Nepal.
Mm-hmm.
Probably the roughest trip I ever took in my life. And I had a few rough trips in South America later on when I was healing myself. but this was rough. This was rough. I mean, you know, a Jewish girl who grew up in the suburbs of New York City, you know, with a country club background.
Yeah. Not going to bow too well over in India, is it?
This did not, you know, all I could do was, on those trains, the only thing that kept me sane was singing every song I'd ever learned in my head.
Hmm.
Wow. Wow. And so it could have been something like a parasite, maybe the
Easily could have been a parasite. Could have been a place in my body which had a lot of emotion.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we've heard a lot about that.
It could have been a lot of things. It could have been my first husband was uncircumcised. He was a man from Cyprus.
Mm-hmm.
And very possibly I've heard stories. And he was a smoker.
Mm.
And so there is research out there recently. There has been some research recently saying that if a man is a smoker, it's possible that the woman could get cervical cancer from the semen.
Isn't that wild? So
yeah. You know where I heard that? You know, in the video, Supercharge Me, 30 Days Raw.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, there was a woman. She said her husband was in the military and that he had just stopped smoking, and she was happy about it because there had been some research about cervical cancer and the semen of a smoking man.
My gosh, I've never heard that before, actually.
Yeah,
wow.
Yeah. So, you know, combination of things, obviously, found, you know, glad that they found it.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time that at what was going on in my life at that time, I was studying a class. There was a little class that had started in a bank building at night on the theory of Chinese medicine.
Mm.
And the man who was teaching the class had just come back from China, and he was so excited about acupuncture. And he was a retired music composition teacher, but he was very energetic. He was probably in his middle 50s. And he eventually went on to become a very famous acupuncturist. And at the time, I said, you know, could I meet with you and discuss something? He said, of course. And I told him what was going on, and he immediately hooked me up with probably the first acupuncturist in the state of Florida who happened to be close by to where, you know, I was living in that area. And this little old, so I went to him, and then he also recommended that I look at the macrobiotic program.
Mm-hmm.
And have a talk with Michio Kushi, mm-hmm. the man who brought macrobiotics to this country. And so I did both those things. And the little Chinese man, an older man, kind of looked like an older man. I think he was about 65 at the time.
Wow. Yeah.
And he had this long, skinny beard. And he just, you know, here's the difference between the freaked out medical doctor when I said I'm going to handle this myself,
uh-huh.
and this little Chinese man just looked at me and he said, no problem, I fix.
Really? I bet that feels good.
Well, you know, we're talking about, what, 6,000 years of history, medical history. You know, the Chinese, when they go to medical school today, they have to study acupuncture. And if they're just going for acupuncture, they also have to study Western medicine.
Mm.
They have to be knowledgeable in both.
Yeah. Yeah, that's amazing. So I bet you felt very confident. You felt very soothed by him saying these things.
Well, it was, you know, it was very surreal. You know, it was a little storefront on top of a storefront in Coral Gables, Florida. Kind of his office was a little messy, and he was a little disheveled. But he said, no problem, I fix. And I'm just wondering if maybe that was the only English he knew.
I know, right? That's the only words he knew.
The one sentence.
Yeah, that's great.
It did me good, though. It did me good.
Yeah, no, that's an amazing thing, because there's such a difference, at least energetically, when you hear news like that or you hear something like that versus a medical doctor. I mean, the difference is night and day, isn't it?
Well, the thing is that our system is just, it's just like, it's so complicated, so complicated, really complicated.
Hmm.
And he boiled it down to energy,
mm-hmm.
because when the acupuncturist examines you, he checks your 12 pulses
mm-hmm.
in your wrists, 6 and 6, and each pulse underlying the heartbeat pulse represents the chi from every single organ in your body.
Isn't that wild? Wow. So he measures that, and then what did he say about you?
He measures that. It takes him about 5 minutes to totally diagnose your whole body.
And what did he say when he did that for you?
Well, he didn't. I don't think he spoke much English. But he invited me into the back, and he made me some soup, and he gave me these funny black tar-looking things that I ate. Whatever he said to do, I did. I had no problem trusting him. I had total problem trusting the medical doctor.
Isn't that wild? Why do you think that was at 29?
Yeah.
Well, I'd been living by frequency, by vibration of people. And this, you know, the medical doctor is like a robot. At least that's what I feel. Many medical doctors are like robots, unless you're with emergency or specific, you know, orthopedics and that kind of thing. But in general, it has become robotic. Mm-hmm. It's not really a pure science anymore. Mm-hmm. It's so complicated with all of the pharmaceutical companies that are putting pressure on doctors and all of the insurance companies that really don't let doctors have a little more time with a patient to just say, what's going on in your life right now? Why do you think you got this? Mm. You know, just like, let's dive in a little deeper here. And, you know, what's your living situation? You know, you have enough money? What's going on? Are you okay?
Right. You can't do that in 7 minutes, can you?
No, you can't. You can't. You can give a shot. You could write a prescription. You could check the vitals. That's just not enough. That's missing. That's an eighth of what's really important.
Right, right. Well, we're going to take a little bit of a break now. I want to pick up with your story when we get back, because this is just amazing, fascinating stuff, and I'm really excited because, you know, it's really important. We have a lot of doctors on, a lot of natural doctors, and discuss a lot of theory and different ideas for healing things, but I think it's really important, too, to get the other side where we talk to survivors, people who have done that, because in my mind, you know, some of these people are more, have better information than doctors because they've done it.
Yeah,
so it's
they've been in the trenches and dug their way out.
Exactly. They've gone through the emotional work. So we're with Jill Schneider, and this is episode 316. Her website, if you guys would like to check it out, she's doing some great stuff, which we'll get into later on in the show. CircleOfLife.net, and there's hyphens between all three words: circle-of-life. CircleOfLife.net, and we'll put that in the chat room. In fact, I will do that right now. CircleOfLife.net, and you can follow her on Facebook. And you can watch on her Facebook page. In the meantime, go check out the Facebook post she did of the 97-year-old lady dancing on the streets of Italy.
I'm going to check that out right now on the break.
So we'll be right back with Jill right after this break.
I wanted to tell you about this really powerful and unique product called the Q Laser. Did you know there's over 2,500 peer-reviewed clinical research studies showing the benefits of low-level laser therapy on the body? We had Dr. Larry Lytle on episode 165 talking all about it. Dr. Lytle, what is the Q Laser?
The Q Laser is a light delivering device, handheld, rechargeable, that is for lay people and professionals, that works at the cell level of the body to restore energy. Since the body is all composed of cells and the cells are composed of atoms, it's good for any and everything in the body. It is especially beneficial for injuries. It will reduce swelling and inflammation before your eyes. Literally, you can have a sprained ankle and apply the laser, and within 30 minutes, you can see that the swelling in the ankle has been reduced. Since all disease is inflammatory, you can assume that same process is working if you have some type of intestinal problem. We have pictures of using a heat instrument to diagnose the intestinal inflammation. We can show that intestinal inflammation is pretty much gone within 3 minutes using the Q1000 laser. It's the number one tool in your medicine cabinet. I have a saying, never leave home without your laser. I have had 3 serious burns, and each time I had my laser with me, I applied the laser immediately after I had the burn. I never even blistered.
Kate and I don't want to be without ours. We've worked out a special deal with Dr. Lytle for all of our listeners. If you'd like to learn more about how the Q Laser can dramatically improve your health, go to extremehealthradio.com/laser. Are you living in the 21st century taking 19th century supplements? Vitamin C pills and powders are often destroyed in the digestive system and passed as waste, never reaching your depleted cells. Lipospheric vitamin C uses a patented encapsulation technology to deliver more without the stomach distress caused by pills and powders. Within minutes, liposomes filled with vitamin C are transported directly into your cells without binders, fillers, sugar, or GMOs. With all the modern advances of medicine and technology, are you throwing away money every morning on inefficient supplements? For under a dollar a day, you could experience the power of lipospheric vitamin C. For a real eye-opener, visit extremehealthradio.com/vitamin C.
100% listener supported. Extreme Health Radio. Opening minds and transforming lives worldwide. Don't forget to join our thriving community for health tips, inspiration, and show updates at extremehealthradio.com/Facebook.
Hello, Hattie.
It's okay, you just got done watching that that video on Jill's Facebook page, didn't you?
Oh my gosh. The lady's sassy.
Was she?
She gets better as it goes. At the beginning, you're laughing, and then she gets a little, she's moving her bum, she's shaking stuff. She's awesome.
Isn't that great?
That made my whole day.
That is so great.
I didn't get to see the whole thing. I'm going to watch the whole thing afterward.
See, there's something about when people heal themselves, or even if people just like that, you know, a 97-year-old lady having fun on the streets. There's something about when you heal yourself, especially of a catastrophic disease like this, it's really important to figure out why and what you're here for. It's one thing to sort of turn your back on something and to heal from something, but then what are you moving towards, you know?
Wow. Completely.
And what change are you going to affect on the world, and how are you going to live and spread your energy and stuff like that, you know?
Well, that woman was spreading the best energy ever, because holy moly, you guys got to check that video out.
I got to see that.
Oh, that's, she's awesome.
So great. This is episode 316. We're with Jill Schneider. Her website is circleoflife.net. I just put that in the chat room if you guys are interested in checking her out. If you guys want to stay up to date with everything we have going on, one of the great ways to do that is through Facebook. We do put our show reminders and archives and upcoming show events and all kinds of things on Facebook. So make sure to sign up, click like, and you'll get our updates. And that would be a great way to stay up to date with everything that we have going on. And Jill, I just want to get back to your story. I'm just still laughing inside about that lady dancing. It's just so funny. I love it.
Well, that, you know, that's what brings us joy. You know, that's the child in us. That's the freedom in us. That's the fearlessness in us.
Right.
She didn't care what anybody was thinking. And of course, as you get older, you really get looser, hopefully.
Uh-huh.
At least I have. You
yeah.
know, I'm not concerned, you know, I am on some level. I'm concerned what people might think of me, certainly professionally and even in my relationships. But if there's something I believe in, I just go for it.
Yeah, that's really important. And what were you doing? Were you doing anything stressful in your life prior to being diagnosed? Was it other than the train trip through India and things like that?
Well, you know, I actually grew up pretty... pretty straight, pretty typical. University, came back to my hometown outside of New York City and taught school for about 6-7 years. But then in between those, you know, teaching gigs, sometimes I would just take off a year and just go travel through Europe and hitchhike and that kind of stuff. So I always had in me this bug, this travel bug. And I also realized that I wasn't really interested in living a typical life. If I already lived in the suburbs, why would I ever want to live there again? I mean, I just didn't really think that I would be happy in that, you know, nuclear family situation.
Right.
You know, I just, it didn't suit me. And then I go to India and I find a teacher there who I've been with now for 41 years. His name is Prem Rawat. And he basically has shown me how to experience peace within myself.
That
it's
is
not a no religion.
How does that look?
How does it feel? It feels wonderful to have peace inside. And it gives you that situation of truly being in the moment, being present, because then your mind is not in the past and your mind is not looking at the future. It doesn't mean that you don't think. It just means that you're present, mm-hmm. even in your thinking, you're present. And you can leave behind mentally and emotionally a lot of stuff that really, I don't want to drag a heavy backpack on this trip. I just went in there and took out 5 pounds. Mm-hmm. And I think tonight I'm going to do another little, few pounds are going to go. Mm-hmm. I want light. I want to live on this planet Earth as light as I can. Actually, I got on the scale yesterday. I'm still my high school weight, 112.
Oh, my gosh.
5'3", 112.
Wow.
Who can say that? Hardly anybody.
I know.
Yeah,
right?
Well, my mother lived till she was 99.
Oh.
She passed just a few months ago.
Oh,
and
my
she
God.
Followed Prevention Magazine up until the day, I'm telling you, a month before she died. She was checking off, turning down pages, and underlying, in Prevention Magazine. So she was always very interested in being beautiful, in being healthy. And I guess that is, something that got passed on to me. I just always felt like it's my responsibility to take care of this incredible human body. And then I took it a step further, because once I started to study meditation and to go very deep inside myself, to really feel that love, feel that energy, feel and even see a light inside myself, mm-hmm. I just felt like it is my responsibility to take care of this human body. This is a gift.
Mm-hmm.
This
mm-hmm.
is truly a gift. And I don't really talk about it that much. I live it. I walk the talk, and that's kind of what I do in terms of my teaching. But one of the other things that I have done probably since 1966 is I've been a guitar player and a singer-songwriter. So I've been in the realm of the creative and always allowing myself those moments to just be in the moment and to allow the energy of that power inside me to come through with a song, with some lyrics, with something, special either for me or for other people. And I've been writing songs for years. And one of my longtime heroes of music from the time I was 13 was Bo Diddley.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And in 1981, I just happened to meet up with Bo Diddley.
Really?
And he gave me a job.
You're kidding me. How did that happen?
No. Really?
I was in my Baroque phase at the time.
Yeah.
And I had a 4-year-old in 1980 and 81. And I had recently gotten a divorce, and I was living in the country in northern central Florida, Gainesville, Florida.
Uh-huh.
And I just happened to I was doing some substitute teaching when a friend of mine was able to watch my son, who also had a son. And then summertime came, and I wasn't working, and I didn't have any money, and I wanted to get out of a living situation that I was in. And the custodian at one of the, really deep south schools, public schools where I was teaching, he said he was the deacon of the church. Of the, Pentecostal church, African-American church. And he said, Jill, if you need to put your trailer somewhere, no problem. I'll even come pick it up. I'll take you over to my back 40. He said, there's no running water. He said, but there's a nice lake where you could clean up. And I laugh because there's alligators in every lake in Florida.
I know. I was just thinking that. That's hilarious.
But he was very generous. And, of course, in exchange, someone offers you something like that, you go to church with him.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to church. He asked me to play the guitar. I played all the gospel songs I had ever learned back in the 60s during the civil rights movement. And it seems that Bo Diddley heard about some white Jewish girl singing in the black church, and he wanted to meet me.
Really? Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my goodness. I saw that picture that you have with him. That's amazing.
Yeah, well, if you go to YouTube and you put in, my middle name is Ayn, you put in Jill, A-Y-N, Bo Diddley,
uh-huh.
A video will come up of me and Bo, and he's playing my original song called Love Sweet Love, unrehearsed with me in his little video studio in his barn.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh.
How much fun is that? That's so amazing.
Well, when you see it, you'll say, whoa.
Wow.
That was fun. So, yeah, you know, I've always kind of been living on the edge. Mm-hmm. That's the bottom line. And, you know, some people can do it and some people can't. But there's still stress.
Mm-hmm.
Not knowing where your next meal is coming from. I really... Because I had grown up with such structure, you know, I guess I rebelled. Mm-hmm. And because I went to India, not that you have to go to India to study meditation, mm-hmm. but I just happened to at that time. And it just meant that I had to test out. I was testing God.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you know, like, okay, so you're supposed to be omnipresent, omniscient, everywhere, totally taking care of my life. Let's test this one out.
Yeah, it's a good test, right?
That's what I'm a tester.
Yeah.
I will test everything out. And that's basically what I was doing when I found out that I had this cancer. Why wouldn't I try a million different things before I would have them take away the possibility of me not being able to have children?
Right, yeah. Right. Yeah, and then you went to, after that, you went to South America too, didn't you?
Well, because I couldn't heal myself in this country. You want to know why?
Yeah. What was the?
How could I rent a place, have a car, have car insurance, have a job, and still heal myself?
Uh huh.
I couldn't. And I tell this to people all the time. You got to take a break. So I took about a 5-month break. What's 5 months in my life?
Mm-hmm.
And I had a little bit of money. And where do you go in those days when you have a little bit of money? You go to South America or Mexico,
mm-hmm.
because you could live on a dollar or two a day. And that's what I did. And I spoke a little bit of Spanish. I went with someone who did speak Spanish very well.
Mm-hmm.
And we just hitchhiked around. And magic happened wherever we went. And I ended up, you know, at the end of that 4.5 months, came back. I knew the cancer was gone.
Really?
I didn't, you know, I just was doing some different kinds of things. But, you know, well, someone's at my door, but they'll have to knock. Anyway.
Well, you know what? We're going to take a little break
right
now.
Yeah, perfect.
All right, good. Let me go get the door then.
Awesome. We'll be right back right after
Thank
this.
You.
So we're with Jill Snyder, and her website is circleoflife.net, and we'll put a link to her website in the chat room, and this is fascinating.
I love this woman.
Isn't she great?
I love her.
She's amazing.
This is awesome.
She reminds us of a good friend of ours that's also in Florida.
In Florida,
that
yeah.
lives near her.
I know. They should be. They're like brothers from another mother.
I know.
Sisters from another mister.
I know.
Hey, when we get back, I want to find out what the heck she had. She changed her diet when she was on that trip. How did she know? Like, I want to know what she was doing.
Yeah, because I want to know how you know that when you get back.
How do you know that? This is good stuff.
Good stuff. Okay,
love
so
it.
We're going to be right back with Jill. This is episode 316, and we'll be right back.
I have to say, I have been absolutely loving this product by Tristan Truscott and Peter Ragnar called Good Morning, Good Evening, Qigong. If you want to listen to the interview we did with Tristan, you can go to extremehealthradio.com/127. And Qigong is a great way to de-stress the body. And as you know, there's a huge component to disease caused by stress. And stress is a huge factor in how we live our lives and the amount of energy we have and the amount of vitality we have. And so, Dr. Shade, what do you think about Qigong?
People come to me and they're really sick and they got this blown out neurological system and all this toxicity. And I tell them, you need to do Qigong Tai Chi. You need to do these things that settle down and restore your neurology, because it puts together all the parts. It puts you back into that state where you can start to detoxify. Mm. And so I highly, highly recommend all that.
And what about you, Kit Campbell? What do you think about Qigong? Do you like it as well?
Qigong is amazing. And the reason that I believe it to be amazing is everything here is energy. That is a scientific fact, if there ever is one. So when you're practicing Qigong, you're actually drawing energy into your body. Your intention, whatever your intention is behind any action, will determine the level of energy, type of energy, that you absorb into your body. So your intention behind your is very important, just like thought. So when you're practicing Qigong, you're actually bringing energy in and you're bringing out the stuff that might be a bit stale. With Tai Chi, it's totally different. The energy runs underneath the skin because it's more of a martial, this is the Chinese understanding, by the way. It's more of a martial art. So Qigong is very, very good for bringing that energy into the body and just fantastic.
If you're interested in picking up this Qigong course by Tristan Truscott and Peter Ragnar, go to extremehealthradio.com/Qigong. That's Qigong. And you can learn more about it. There's a great video on that page, and you can learn more about it on that page. And I highly, highly recommend this product. I love it myself. So go ahead and check that out. extremehealthradio.com/Qigong. Feel younger and feel healthier. Harness the power of the sea through S&C, delivering you whole body wellness. S&C supplements are specifically formulated using active sea-based minerals at levels that correspond directly to the nutritional makeup of the human body. The unique and original S&C product line is enhanced by the legendary Dr. Ron Cusson's proprietary processing technology, increasing the efficiency and speed of nutrient delivery into our system. Achieve optimal hydration and mineral balance, decalcify the body to provide rapid relief from chronic diseases and ailments like inflammation and digestive dysfunctions. S&C is a life-restoring solution to ensure optimal health and wellness. Visit extremehealthradio.com/CSEA today and discover the secret to eternal youth. If you enter the coupon code Justin, J-U-S-T-I-N, you'll get a 20% discount on all orders for a limited time. So why wait to be well? Go to extremehealthradio.com/C.
Free shows all the time on Extreme Health Radio. Opening minds and transforming lives worldwide. Join our community today. Sign up to our email list and instantly get our free gift to you, along with loads of inspirational content and cutting-edge tips to help change your life at extremehealthradio.com/subscribe.
Alrighty, I think everybody's unmuted there. That's good, that's good. Getting the old soundboard working correctly, hopefully.
I had my microphone about 8 feet above my head. I just had to pull that back down. It's no good having the levels good if your microphone's way up
in
the air.
That's right, you can't hear. We have some great guests coming up this week. If you guys want to follow us on our newsletter series, that's probably the best way. That way you get the complete updates sent right to your email inbox. You get a free ebook called Lessons from the Miracle Doctors, which sells for $20 on Amazon, so you can check that out. But we got a great show on Wednesday with Dr. Larry Lytle. We're going to be discussing in further detail some of the more interesting aspects of this laser that we've been using for the last few months. Really fascinating guy. And then we have Dr. Susan Smith Jones on Thursday. And then on Friday, we have our Free for All Friday show. Next week, we have Dr. Gabriel Cousins from the Tree of Life.
Nice.
So that'll be fun. So if you want to keep up to date with all of that and the weekly recaps and archives of our shows, sign up to our newsletter and every Sunday you'll get a recap of the previous week's shows. And if there's anything that interests you, you can check that out on our newsletter list. And let me just unmute Jill here. And Jill, we wanted to ask you, because we know that you are doing a lot of juice fasting and juice retreats now.
Yes.
And we want to get to that. Later on, but I wanted
Absolutely.
To ask you, how did you know when you were in South America and you were going through all this and you came back, how did you know that you were cancer-free? What did you do in South America?
Actually, it was very interesting. Do you hear that echo? You fixed it. Okay, good.
Good.
I was, don't forget, I had done some acupuncture for about a month before I left for this journey. Mm-hmm. And then I went to the doctor again, to another doctor, and the pap test had gone from a 5 to a 3. So I knew something was changing. And I had followed the program that Michio Kushi had told me to do, which was for 10 days just eat brown rice, just brown rice for 10 days, and to chew each biteful 100 times.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my gosh.
So it's like a liquid brown rice fast.
And that's kind of challenging to do with something, those little tiny
grains of rice.
Grains of rice, yeah.
Well, you know, I mean, I saw how important chewing was. Really, really important. So I was doing that, and wherever I traveled, I actually carried brown rice with me. Mm-hmm. And wherever I went, if I went into a city, I was usually able to find the one health food store in Caracas, another one in Lima, Peru.
Uh-huh.
And then, you know, vegetables and sesame seeds. At that point in time, I was, you know, just kind of eating mostly cooked, because in South America, you really couldn't just eat anything raw, unless it was like an orange or a banana, you could peel it. That was okay.
Right.
But I was mostly eating quite a strict macrobiotic diet, and I felt good. I was hiking. I was, you know, sleeping well. You know, these are indications that, you know, the body is comfortable with itself. So I was feeling more and more comfortable. And by the time I ran out of money, it was about the time to go back. Mm-hmm. So, you know, and what had happened was, just the week before I left South America, I had been traveling with a very well-known teacher of yoga named Swami Satchitananda.
Mm-hmm.
And I was part of his entourage, and he was traveling through Venezuela. And I was watching him like a hawk. He just was, he was 65 at the time. He looked like he was 35.
Wow.
And he and I kind of went off and did this hot mud in a place where they have hot volcanic water and stuff. And I did this hot mud thing with him, covered my whole body with the hot mud. And when I got back to where I was staying that night, I broke out into a terrible rash and a fever. And it was like, I just knew this was the end. This was the time. And I, my friend put garlic, chopped up garlic, and wrapped it around the bottom of my feet to get rid of the, you know, real old-fashioned stuff.
I know, right?
And chamomile foot baths. And the next day I got up, I felt great. The rash was gone. The fever was gone. And I didn't smell so good, but I took a shower and, you know, just went on to get ready to, you know, go back to the United States.
Wow. And so you probably had some good support from your family, right? Because it sounds like your mom was pretty switched on.
I never told anybody.
Oh, you
didn't? No way.
That's right. Yeah, that's right. I remember that. So you didn't tell anybody.
Only this friend of mine who I was traveling with and a couple other friends knew, but I didn't tell my family.
So was that for specific reasons?
Yeah. And because I've been in this field for a long time now, and as soon as you tell your loved ones, they take over.
Mm-hmm.
They make you feel guilty if you don't do chemotherapy and radiation.
Wow. And so when you were doing these types of things, going to South America and things, what did they think? Did they think you're just going for fun kind of thing?
You know, my mother and I had this kind of relationship where, you know, she knew I was, you know, I don't listen to anybody.
Uh-huh.
You know, and she had given me an education, and I was appreciative of that. And, you know, we really didn't have a great relationship our whole life.
Mm-hmm.
But I was different. You know, I didn't like shopping.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I used to get headaches doing things like that.
Yeah.
Anyway, you know, just the expectations of the way she lived and the way she would have wanted a daughter to live. I never really lived up to that.
Hmm.
So, but, you know, I really think we have a problem here with, you know, anyone who's listening who has a problem with a disease, and especially cancer. And it's very hard for you, you know, to make a real decision in your life. I get a lot of calls from people who say, you know, I want to just go all natural, and what do you recommend? And, you know, I think it's just we're railroaded, we're corralled into this one way you know, helps all, and it's not true.
Mm-hmm.
And I would just say, hey, you know, they may have just discovered this, but it's been there for a while,
mm-hmm.
you know, and you're not dead yet. So why don't you do something like, you know, clean your body out, get your immune system working, do everything you possibly can to boost yourself. And then if you still after that decide that you want to have some surgery or have some chemotherapy and radiation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's fascinating.
You'll be better.
It's really, you know, to me, this a story like this hits home because I had a friend in high school who had cancer a while back. She had a colon cancer, and she had known what I do and all that. And so we talked on the phone, and I asked her about doing natural therapy, you know, and she said she ended up passing away about a year and a half ago. And what she told me at the time, she said, well, if I don't continue doing the chemotherapy and the radiation, my parents will kill me.
And look at what killed her.
One way or the other, she knew she was going to die.
I know, right? Yeah. And I just thought,
what a statement. What a statement.
Isn't that powerful?
Kill me. That's really powerful.
Isn't that just amazing?
Well, it's true. And that's why I have just lived my life on my own terms. And fortunately, my son knows that. And I never would have had my son if it wasn't for not letting them give me a hysterectomy.
Yeah.
And now I have two little girl grandchildren.
Which all would never have been here.
Never. And the joy of being a grandmother, I would have missed that. The joy of being a mother, I would have missed.
Isn't that just crazy? Wow. And so
it's crazy.
So you would have had more resistance from not just your mother, but maybe other members of your family as well, do you think?
I don't think my father, you know, he wasn't. He didn't know about that stuff, and even my mother at that time didn't really know much. But why get them worried?
Uh-huh.
Why even worry? If you really care about your family, why tell them?
Well,
because
then
they just put more fear onto you.
And why give it more power, too? Because once you kind of own that, then there you go.
Yep.
I'm telling you that I'll say that there's probably 75% of your listeners, something like that, have been in that situation, and they've gone ahead and done the chemotherapy just to get their family off their back.
Hmm.
And inside, deep down inside, they knew that wasn't the way to go.
Hmm. Yeah, it's a powerful thing because you're almost drawing a line in the sand. You know, you're saying, this is the direction I'm going. This is what I'm doing, and I'm protecting that whole space so much so that I'm not going to tell anybody. You know,
right, right.
Yeah,
I trust that, you know, deeper inner part of myself more than any doctor.
Uh-huh. It's a powerful thing. So did you do, did you continue on? Did you do things like colonics or did you continue on with the macrobiotic diet and things?
Yeah, actually, just shortly before I met up with Bo Diddley, and I, by the way, we were friends for 25 years, and I worked for, he gave me a job. I had no money.
Hmm.
And he gave me a job, and I lived on his ranch for about a year and a half. And then after that, I met up with some people. Before that, I met up with some folks, and we were sort of doing little, you know, we rented a house together, and they had kids, and it was when I was still married. Mm-hmm. And we were juicing up a storm, and we had a backyard colonic machine.
Oh, did you really?
Did you?
Dug a little trench or someplace for it to go, and man, we learned a lot. We learned a lot.
Isn't that
amazing?
And
we read every book by Dr. Walker and Pavo Arola and Dr. Harvey Kellogg and all the great, and what's his name? And I didn't have Gersten at the time.
Oh, right.
Who else? Oh, Arnold Arendt.
Oh, he was amazing.
Professor Arnold Arendt.
He was
great. The Mucusless Diet System.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's a great book.
I've read that too.
Yeah, it's an amazing book.
That was probably my first book. Now, talk about a guy who looks like Rasputin.
Mm-hmm.
I know, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's got a fire in his
and
eyes.
And is speaking such truth that you know that our culture is so off.
Mm-hmm.
So when
he
you were
walked through Europe and picked grapes and ate grapes and. You know, he healed himself that way.
I remember he was doing some experiments on himself, and he would do. He was this great a man who did all these experiments on himself, and he would eat like a really poor diet for like a week, and then he would cut himself, and then he would see how long it would take his body to heal, and then he would change his diet and do more like a fruit plant based diet, and he would cut himself and see how long it took him to heal, and he would do all these amazing. Experiments. He was a fascinating guy, wasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
But most people are so caught up in this culture and with their families, and they've lost themselves. And because of that, I believe, and I know you probably will have seen it too, there's a pervasive depression going on in our culture.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there is.
It's just pervasive. Even the most successful people out there, and even if they're thin and trim and supposedly eating right, there's this fog around them.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think's causing that?
I think they're not being true to themselves.
You think so?
I think so. I think we know from, you know, as children, when I see my grandchildren, they're just so incredible. Mm. And I'm so grateful to my son and daughter-in-law for taking such wonderful care of them. They're even thinking at this point to homeschool. Right now, the 4.5-year-old is in a public school pre-K program.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, she's exceptional and she needs the socialization, but at the same time, the concepts of the way things are done educationally, oh my God. Even in the best of the schools. I was a school teacher back in the day when there was plenty of money in the schools and they let us experiment and we were asking the children, what do you want in the classroom? And they would design the classroom. And we were, you know, everything was very individualized and we were teaching children according to their passions. If they loved fish, they loved frogs or whatever, the whole curriculum for them would be based on their passions.
Wow. Golly, that's just a relic, isn't it?
Yeah. So I was already on the edge. And it was a very incredible revolutionary time.
Yeah, I think that there's a lot of that stuff going on. Like you said, I saw you posted something recently about Robin Williams. And, you know, I just think that I think it has a lot to do with what you said. People aren't being true to themselves and people aren't listening to what they want. And a lot of people
are
doing
what everybody else wants them to do and not do what they want to do. Mm.
Yeah, they're just running someone else's script and plan for their life. It's amazing.
Right. Right. And so it's no wonder that they're depressed.
Mm. Mm.
And they don't even. You know, they don't even know that. Mm-hmm. That's how depressed they are.
They're so deep in it.
And then they take these ridiculous antidepressants. And I get a lot of women. I have most of my business is women.
Uh-huh.
And I get a lot of women coming to me. And I don't tell them not to get off of it while they're even doing my program. I mean, I'm not a doctor. I'm not going to play with that at all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But, you know, we do talk about, you know, why they're on it and what it does for them. And I did have one man actually say, Jill, I just want to come to see you and I want you to help me to get on the antidepressant because he had just gone through a divorce and he was very anxious. I said, you know, in this case, it's important for you to get on that antidepressant in order to function. So he came to me. And for the 5 days, he started taking the antidepressants and just wanted to, you know, have someone there who would help him at least to make sure he's eating properly.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't a fast. We didn't do a fast. He also wanted to grieve. He had never grieved for the loss of his mother when he was 9 years old.
Oh, my goodness.
And he was in his 60s when he came to me. And he trusted me, and I trusted him because he's turned out that even though we met through the internet, he's like the cousin of a very dear friend of mine.
Oh,
so I felt like, yeah, I can hold you while you cry.
Wow.
So, you know, my work is interesting. You know, it'll cover a lot of ground. Because when people fast, and that is essentially what I do, I create a fasting situation. in a beautiful hotel one block from the ocean. I bring in all the fruits and vegetables and the juicer, and I go to town, and I make sure that they're getting quadruple or more, maybe even 20 times of the vitamins and minerals by putting this juice in their body and going for colon hydrotherapy and going to the ocean every day and swimming in the ocean and walking along the ocean and breathing the ocean air and doing some stretching and yoga by the ocean. And what happens is that all of the baggage just starts coming, rearing up every day to something new, something old is creeping up out of this person that they need to talk about. And I just let them talk.
Yeah, they have to get the stuff off their back, don't they?
Yeah, just get it off your back, and I don't tell them what to do or anything like that.
Wow.
I'm a listener.
Fascinating. Okay,
we have a question in the chat room in regards to juicing.
Okay.
Let's see. Our friend Hayden says, my diabetic numbers are high. My blood sugar numbers reduce when I juice fast low glycemic vegetables and fruits. Can Jill recommend something to add to my juice to help bring the numbers down? Do you know of that?
Well, you know who would really know that? Dr. Gabriel Cousins, because he has been working with diabetics, type 1 and type 2, very successfully. Even has tell this person to go on YouTube and watch a whole video all about working with diabetics.
Okay.
But it sounds like she's already doing juices that are low glycemic. Mm-hmm. So that's what I would recommend. The other thing that I make for my clients is a broth, and I add a lot of seaweed, and it's very warming and comfortable. You just kind of, the end of the day especially, or after you've had a colonic, you just want to come home and have my broth.
Yeah, right.
It just makes you feel so good. You know, you want that salty, and, you know, just I put shiitake mushrooms in there and onions, carrots, potatoes. You know, it's the Jensen.
Oh, right.
Broth, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, the Bernard Jensen.
Bernard Jensen, I believe it was him. And, you just need a broth. You need something warm.
I know that you mentioned Dr. Norman Walker a little while ago. And when he in one of his books, mentioned about how long people should do, or how often, I guess, people should do colonics. And he said twice a year, six sessions twice a year. So I guess that would mean something like 2 weeks, or two per week for 3 weeks, twice a year. But I'm just wondering, what do you do for your colonics? Do you have any set schedule for them, or how do you do those?
Personally, no. I just kind of wait for my body not to feel quite right. And then I actually have a Kalima board, which I can create my own colon session in my own bathroom.
Uh-huh.
And I don't know if people want to know about Kalima, that they can look it up. That's also on Bernard Jensen's site. It's a way to make your little bathroom into a little colonic place yourself.
Yeah, I've heard of that. Can you explain that a little bit further?
Yeah, a little bit.
I don't know how it quite works, but I've heard of them
before.
Yeah.
Well, it's a big bucket, and the bucket has a tube coming out of it.
Uh-huh.
And you got to put the bucket up high, and then there's this board that goes over the toilet and a chair, and you adjust it because the board has a hole in it where you're going to put your butt.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And, at a slant, slight little slant, and you get comfortable on this board. You put some towels and, just make it really, really soft.
Uh-huh.
And you just kind of climb aboard.
How long does that usually take, that whole process?
Well, same as a regular colonic, 45 minutes, an hour.
Okay.
Yep. And use a little castor oil on the speculum.
Mm-hmm.
And just be quiet and light some candles and play some soft music and
And what breathe. What about enemas? Do you do those?
Yeah, if I'm in a little bit of a hurry and I'm feeling like, I got to get something out of here, I will definitely, and I bring enema bags for my clients if they choose to do it every day. When you're fasting, in the early days, And even for myself, when I do fast, I do an enema every day, and sometimes every day and every night.
Really? Just a regular water one?
Yeah, just water. Or sometimes I can put a little, lemon juice in there. You know, you filter it, strain it. And sometimes a little clay, a little calcium bentonite clay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's amazing. We've heard a lot of people doing a lot of nutraceuticals in the enemas as well, on top of coffee. So,
yeah, and then besides the coffee enema too, you got the wheatgrass. You can put some wheatgrass, or you can do an implant at the very end.
Yeah, we've heard a lot of people doing those, especially with the Hippocrates Institute, which is near you. People doing wheatgrass implants.
Yeah, yeah, and also near you is the Optimum Health Institute.
That's
and they
true.
Do it as well. If you haven't seen the movie Supercharge Me, 30 Days Raw, it's a really excellent film, something I really highly recommend that people watch. And it's a woman who documented her journey of 30 Days Raw and how she cleaned out and how her life changed.
Isn't that awesome? Yeah,
I haven't seen it, though.
Yeah, that's a popular one, 30 Days Raw.
Yeah, it's popular, not as popular as Joe Cross, who I got to meet, by the way, a couple of years ago.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, he came through Miami, and I said to my client, I said, hey, Joe's going to be in Miami Beach tonight. And she said, let's go. I said, I'm going. We're going. Let's do it. And it's about an hour and 15 minutes from where I live and where we work out of. And we went down there, and it was at a Whole Foods. And he just moseyed on in. Wouldn't have necessarily known unless you had seen his picture or seen the movie. And this was about 3 years ago, actually, maybe two and a half, whatever. And he was just as humble can be. And in the movie, you can see that as well, personable. And at the end of his wonderful talk about the power of healing and through juicing and putting all these wonderful vitamins and minerals in your body in a very pure way, not making your body work very hard. Somebody raised their hand in the back of the group. There were about 50 people, really, you know, who had come, and we were all kind of packed into a small area. And they said, and he was so sweet, he said, Joe, do you have any problems? And Joe says, yeah, I got problems with women. And my mother. And yeah, she's a woman too.
I love that man.
That's so good.
How could you not love him? He's just lovable.
We were watching the trailer for his second movie that's coming out this week.
Great.
Yeah.
I'm so glad.
Woohoo.
Yeah,
Joe's amazing.
Yeah, we
amazing,
love
amazing.
So people can find out more about your retreats, and people can work with you as a client, right?
Yes, absolutely. I tend to work with only one or two people at a time. And if they're interested, if they forgot those, you know, the URL, the domain name, just put in Circle of Life Holistic Programs, and I'll come right up. Or even if you just put in Juice Fasting Retreat, I usually come up for a second or third.
Okay.
Great.
And so you guide and coach people. And how long are some of these retreats that people do? How long would they do the fasting?
I do 5-day ones, and I do 10-day ones.
Wow,
that sounds... I won't do any longer than that.
Because then you're getting into some uncharted territory a little bit, right?
Well, I think that's extreme enough.
Mm-hmm. Five and 10-day. That's amazing.
Long.
Yeah, and the thing is, you know, I have to be very careful, because there's a lot of people out there who go from, you know, eating a Twinkie to, you know, coming to my fast. You know, so I need to find out who these people are. And I'm not just going to take anybody.
Yeah, it's pretty dangerous, too, going on a swing like that.
It could be. But, you know, in 17 years, I've never had a problem.
Wow. Golly, that's so great. So how often do you do the fasts?
Pretty much every week.
Oh, really? So people can sign up and go?
Yeah, wow, they can call me if they're interested. 561-638-8873. And we'll talk about, I already have two people booked when I come back from Italy. So my opening right now is the beginning of November.
How fun.
Wonderful.
And so you can or they can contact you, and then they can hang out with you, and you can kind of coach them.
Right. I spend 4 to 6 hours a day with the client, making sure they're comfortable. I bring in I've been a massage therapist for 30 years, and I've just sort of called it not total quits. I'm just doing the reflexology, aromatherapy, and castor oil packs on the client. And then the integrative massage that is included in the program. I have a couple other massage therapists who do that work for me.
That is so cool.
Yeah, no, so I mean, cool. I've been a body worker, serious body worker, for 30 years. Hmm. Actually, I just got an email from someone who's interested in learning how to do barefoot shiatsu. And that's what I did on Bo Diddley for 25 years.
Oh, really?
I stepped on him.
You had to get to where you were going.
Yeah, I did. And he would come back from a gig. I pretty much lived in his house, took care of his kids and his wife. And I was, he would come back from a gig and he'd be pretty exhausted. And he literally would throw his stuff on a chair and then he would just lay on the carpeted floor. Hmm. And he'd say, "Jill, please mash on me."
Oh, wow.
And I did.
That's so cool. You know, it's funny in today's world. I know, Kate, you talked about this on our last Friday show, but it seems as though, in today's world, a lot of people are getting more and more, I don't know, they feel guilty for going and getting a massage.
This is ridiculous.
It's crazy, isn't it? You know, this whole self-care thing, people are
people think it's selfish.
I know. Yeah. I had a woman say to me 2 weeks ago, I feel like this is so selfish. Selfish? Where does that come from? You gotta look at that. That's really sick.
Isn't it?
That's really sick. That's a sick way of thinking, because in reality, the healthier you get, the better you feel, the more energy you have, gives you more energy, more love to be able to help someone else.
Yeah, it's so true. We see that a lot. People are trying to put guilt on other people for spending $70 on a massage or whatever they're doing. It's crazy.
It is totally crazy. So this is another reason why it's best not to tell anybody that you're coming to see Jill Schneider to do a juice fasting retreat.
I know, right?
Isn't that the truth?
Keep it under wraps.
And the other thing is that I really don't get too many referrals at all from people who've been here, because if you think of your closest friends, and they don't want to hear the idea of fasting. It brings up the whole primal hunger thing.
Right, mm-hmm. Right. Right, right. People want to eat.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a fascinating thing. I hope that, in times to come, people are going to start changing their mind and start taking care of themselves more and spending money on that.
Well, I think they are to a degree, but and I mean, I get people who have saved their money and saved their money to come to see me. Mm-hmm. And then I get people who, are just so wealthy it doesn't matter,
Right.
And I really, I try to give those other people who don't have the money a little bit of a break to help pay for the, and then the people who have the money, I charge them my regular price. And, I get to meet all kinds of people. It's wonderful.
That's so cool. So people on your website, you got a whole resources section on how to prepare for the fast, why you should fast, and then the master cleanser. Then you have all kinds of really cool products and services there, too, that people can find.
Right.
That's so cool. CBD hemp oil for health, IV chelation and high-dose vitamin therapy from Paul Cotterham, MD. That's so cool. You have holistic lifestyle coaching.
Actually, he's the doctor that oversees. He's the attending physician for the Hippocrates Institute, but he also has a clinic, an urgent care clinic, just down the road from me. And I'm going over there tomorrow before I leave for this trip to get an infusion of vitamin C and B vitamins and some glutathione.
Oh, I love it. I love it. Wow, Jill. Well, thank you so much for being on and for sharing your story with us. And I think a lot of people are going to get some really amazing inspiration and motivation and
good.
Learn a lot.
Thank you so much. And I'm really proud of you guys.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Jill.
Yeah, it's really a wonderful thing. Wonderful thing. I'm very, very excited about, meeting people who are, just excited and passionate about their health. I mean, and not feeling guilty.
Yeah.
I mean,
well, you are an true inspiration. It's just so awesome. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
All right, Jill.
Call on me anytime.
Oh, I would love to. Stay on the line. Hold on there really quickly.
Okay.
We're going to close out our live show, and I want to thank everyone for being on the live show. We really appreciate this.
Thanks, everybody in the chat room. That's such a party in there today, and everybody's just talking away about stuff with their health, so it's great.
It's really cool. Got a ton of people in there. So if you guys would like to join the chat room, we're live 4 days a week, Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, at 9 a.m. Pacific, and you guys can join the chat room at extremehealthradio.com/live, and on Wednesday, we have Dr. Lytle, and then on Thursday, we have Dr. Susan Smith-Jones, and then Friday, we get to talk about all of our guests behind their back, but it's just a great time, and so we're really excited to be here for you guys, and if you ever need anything, please let us know. We want to just thank all you guys for being on a live show. We really appreciate it. Thank you so much. We'll catch you on the next episode.
Wonderful.
And at the end here, Kirstie says, great show. I really love Jill. Everybody loves you.
Oh, good.
This is great.
Thank you. Wonderful. All right. Well, you have a wonderful day.
Okay. Thanks so much, Jill.
Have a great trip to Italy,
yeah,
Jill.
Have fun.
Thank you. I will.
Enjoy your birthday festivities.
Absolutely.
Awesome.
Okay, honey.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right. Well, that was an awesome show. She was quite the fireball. We've got a lot to talk about. We're going to take a little break and we'll be right back.
Hey, guys. If you've been following our work for any length of time, you know that I'm a big fan of raw food. I did a raw food diet, actually, from 2003 to 2010, 100%, and I loved it. And raw food is a huge part of my diet, and I just love it. And if you're interested in making healthy, really amazing raw food dishes without spending hours and hours in the kitchen, I would highly recommend checking out a program put together by Russell James called the Raw Chef Program. You could check it out at extremehealthradio.com/raw chef. And I have to say, it's absolutely incredible. I have it, and it's got hundreds of hours of video, professionally done video along with workbooks and PDF files. And he walks you through how to make the most amazing, delicious raw food meals that don't take forever. Everything from mock pizzas and pasta to ice cream to cheese to fluffy bread, if you can imagine it. It's incredible. So I highly recommend you checking it out. You can check it out at extremehealthradio.com/raw chef. And I think you are absolutely going to love this program. So check it out now. So I think moving into the year 2013 and beyond, we're going to have to get really creative and develop a strategy of how to get healthy and the ways to get medicines into our body that are unique and specialized. And I first heard of nebulizing from David Wolf. If you want to listen to his episode, it's episode number 35. But he talks about nebulizing different medicines. And what that means is turning liquids into a smoke, basically, that you can breathe in. And the pharmaceutical and drug industries use these things for patients to take pharmaceutical drugs and nebulize them so patients can breathe them into their lungs. But we're very proud to be offering what I think is the best nebulizer on the market. It's called the Omron Personal Nebulizer, and you can check it out at extremehealthradio.com/Omron. That's O-M-R-O-N, and that will redirect you to a page where you can buy that. And it's really great because you can put in natural substances like colloidal silver or MMS, developed by Jim Humble, and things that will kill on contact viruses and things that are taking place in your lungs. And it's a good way to get these medicines into your body. And I think that as we move forward, people are going to be sicker and sicker. And if you have a cold or any kind of throat issue, if I ever had cancer, I'd probably use a nebulizer. And the Omron is really great because you can travel with it. It's really portable and it runs on batteries, and it's really the best nebulizer on the planet. So if you're interested in this kind of thing and want to use these types of things, I think it's really critical if you're traveling a lot or if you have a family, you want to just have this on hand, almost like in your medicine chest, so that if you ever need it, you can nebulize these colloidal silvers and MMS and other substances to breathe directly into your lungs to kill these pathogens and viruses and all these things that are living inside your lungs and your bloodstream and stuff. So it's very, very interesting. So these Omron portable nebulizers are a great way to do that. So you can check it out, extremehealthradio.com/Omron, O-M-R-O-N, or you can visit our store and learn more about it in there. So thanks for listening, and let's get back to the show. Well, Jill Schneider, she is just such a fun person, isn't she?
Isn't she?
Yeah.
Kirsty in the chat room says she sounds like a firecracker. Hard to believe she is 69. I know.
I know, right?
See, don't you just love that age is not a factor if you are healthy?
It is. I know.
That's the thing. That's the difference.
And she has a very young, Jill has a very young approach.
Youthful way about her.
And I can say that I relate a lot with her. I really do because she's got that kind of fiery, rebellious personality. You know, people aren't going to tell her what to do.
Yeah, you can't push her around. You can't.
I love that. Yeah.
She really inspires me. It just makes me want to like... I don't know. I mean, you and I were talking yesterday when we were up in the hills of Montecito hiking around about, you know, the travel days we've had have just been amazing. We've done a lot of traveling together as time has gone by. And there's something great about when kind of coming into a space where you feel like you want a little bit more roots. We still want to take a little vacations here and there, but we used to be much more travel-y adventure. But my gosh, when you talk to somebody like her, you're like, screw it, throw it all out the window. I just want to go places and I want to live life and watch the 97-year-old woman dance on the streets and, you know, go live on these organic farms. I mean, she just fires me up. I feel like I got to go do something in the world, you know?
Have you seen that video of that lady, that grandma dancing where it's like the granddaughter or the daughter's in the car?
Pulls up in the car to grab her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the grandmother is just dancing and she looks like she's probably in her 90s.
Oh my gosh.
And
it's hilarious.
Feisty and fiery.
Oh yeah. Feisty and fiery. Nope. You know, I think those people live for a long time, to be honest. Like, that's what probably keeps them going. I mean, that little old lady that she has on her, that Jill has on her Facebook page, mm-hmm. is, I was watching that at the break, you know, at the first commercial, and I thought, it's probably her love of dance she's 97. I mean, because she's all hunched over. This woman does not look like the picture of health, you know, by any means. And she could be, I don't know, but she just doesn't look that healthy. But uh-huh. I'm thinking, you know what, the fact that she gets up and probably just entertains people all day and brings joy to people and love, you can tell she loves to dance, mm-hmm. that probably keeps her going.
Yeah, there's a certain, you know, I feel like with people like that, there's a certain element of a spark of life that sort of presupposes or sort of, I guess not presupposes, but goes above your diet and your, mm-hmm. even the toxins you're exposed to.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this zest for life is, I think, probably one of the most important things, even more important maybe than diet and cleansing and all that kind of stuff too.
Mm.
You know? I mean, there are people that do have that zest for life, and because of such a poor diet and exposures to toxins, they do get things and get diagnosed with things. But if you combine the two, a zest for life with a clean lifestyle, man, you get someone like Jill, and she's just a firecracker.
Yeah.
She's just so cool.
When those two things come together, look at what it looks like.
I know, right?
The picture of it is Jill.
Yeah, so she was 29, so I was 40, so she's 69, and she's going to Italy by herself. How cool is that?
Sounds like she's done it for the last 4 or 5 years.
And she goes, and she's going to rent a car.
I love her.
It's amazing what you can do. I mean, she started her health journey at 29, and look at the fire and the zest she has now. And it's like, I know people that are 10 years younger than she is that are afraid to drive, that don't want to drive at night.
Don't want to travel by themselves.
They're
wouldn't dream of that.
Negative.
Mm-hmm.
And, eat a processed food diet. And you see what it does to people.
Yep.
And I think that as you get older, the difference of what you are and what you could have been gets greater and greater and greater. And there's no way for you to compare the two because, you know, the person who you could have been is not here because you are a different person.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Like, so you can't compare yourself, but what you could have been and what you end up being, if you take care of yourself, are almost night and day. They're not even the same people.
Wow.
I mean, imagine if Jill had never taken care of herself. I mean, she probably wouldn't be here, for one. But if she were, she could have been, you know, someone who is very negative or someone who...
Yeah.
Who was in a rest home or...
Yeah.
I mean, 69 is not even old.
No, it's not.
You know?
No.
But she could be in living a life like that.
Man, people like her and Louise Hay, it's like if you wake up and you get on the right track, look at how much life you could have missed out on and look at what you do have to offer the world because you took the hint and went for it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I know. With Jill, it's like she wouldn't have had a son, you know, if they would have taken all her reproductive organs out.
Right.
She definitely wouldn't have had any grandchildren and wouldn't have had any of the stuff that brings her fullness in life.
Right. It's just...
Wow.
I
do love how she touched a lot on the emotional aspect of it, because I'm strongly believing every dis-ease, like she was saying, dis-ease.
Right, right.
Has an emotional background and component to it, for sure. I mean, you know, my stuff I've been going through, I know it's, you know, partly, probably a big part emotional, but it's so funny when you don't know what those emotions are. You don't know what the heck they are, but you know it's part of it, you know?
Right.
It's really hard to decipher at what point did something affect you so much that there was a physical disturbance, you know?
That's why I think meditation is so key to do on a daily basis, because you could do meditation, you know, like we do the Qigong that we ran the ad for, and we do, it's possible to do like a sort of like a Zazen thing where you do a meditation in the moment while you're driving and things. But I think that a regular practice of being quiet and being with yourself, I think, is huge. I got to get back onto that because I was on it for a long time and I just got off. Hmm. It's like one of the...
It's easy to do.
It's
so easy to do.
Yeah. And
especially when you're putting your all into everything. That's how I feel like you're spread a little thin sometimes, and not because you don't want to do these things. You just want to do everything, that it gets, you know, it's really hard to keep up on everything all the time. But
that's true.
Doesn't mean you can't pick it up today. That's what I keep telling myself. And like Amy Schuber was on and she was talking about ease and grace with things. Mm-hmm. We'll put a link to that episode. But
right.
If we just give ourselves a little ease and grace, and you're not doing it out of, you know, a place of beating yourself up, is when it's, you know, you just add it back in and you go from there. And
yeah, there's no judgment.
It's all good. No judgment. Otherwise, you're undoing everything you've done tenfold. And like, what's the point of that?
Yeah. Yep. Well, if you guys would like to follow Jill, sign up to her newsletter list, you can do all that by going to circleoflife.net. And we'll put a link to that on extremehealthradio.com/316. That's where you're going to find everything. Pretty cool. I just love people like her. She's so great. I love... You know, I want to have that much energy, and I want to have that much zest for life, and I want to have that kind of an impact. And, you know, she doesn't seem like she's depressed or down or lacking something or feels like she needs something in her life. I mean, she's just content and happy and helping people and full of life.
She does.
You know? It's cool.
She's putting me to shame. I'm on her her website right now. Uh-huh. And my gosh, she has all of her tracks and songs up here for purchase through iTunes, it looks like.
Really?
For 99 cents. I can't wait to get off this show and listen to some of these, because I bet her song, the way she lives life, are obviously reflected in her music as an artist. I mean, the titles of these, the first one's Take All the Fear. The second one, Meant to Be. It just gets simple. I mean, I'm sure that she has a song called Make Your Work Your Play. The people shall continue for the love inside. Wow. You can just tell that they're going to be amazing lyrics, and I can't wait to see this talent.
Where did you find? Did you go to Jill's songwriting and music?
I did. Yeah, I did. Exactly.
Oh,
for
on
her.
The left-hand side.
Uh-huh.
Ah, okay. So this is like, it goes to a different website. Okay.
Isn't this awesome?
This is cool. Hey, what was that thing that she mentioned? Let me go to YouTube right now. And she mentioned something about typing Bo Diddley and Jill Ann Schneider. Is that what it was?
Mm-hmm.
Let me do that. Bo Diddley.
Ayn, A-Y-N. That's
Jill.
How she pronounced it.
I wanted to ask her if that has any relation to
Ayn Rand.
Ayn Rand. S-C-H.
I know.
Let's see. Bo Diddley. Oh, no way. Look at that. We'll put a link to that video.
Yeah, can you send that to me?
Yeah, Jill, it just says Jill Ann. Or Jill Ayn. J-I-L-L-A-Y-N. And Bo Diddley. At 3:53.
That is nice. Cool. I know what I'm watching and listening to the minute we get off this show.
That is cool.
She's a fascinating woman.
She's great. She's really great. So I just hope you guys got some inspiration out of that. The whole reason why we have people like her is for that inspiration, because it's one thing to listen to a doctor who's never been diagnosed with anything. It's great to listen to them. They have all kinds of great theory and some great tips, great advice for people to implement and do, and a lot of really amazing cutting-edge strategies to use. But they haven't been through the journey themselves. And I think that we like to present both types of people to you so that you can get the inspiration, the motivation, work with someone like Jill, and also get the theory and the strategies and disciplines and things from the doctors. So it's kind of a double-edged sword there.
I love it.
Yeah.
You need both sides to have the complete thing, you know?
Got to have both sides. All right. So this is episode 316. All of our shows are free. If you guys would like to support us through a donation, or through going to our store and purchasing any of our products in our store, which has got some amazing products on there. Also, you can go through Amazon and do your shopping, all your Amazon shopping.
And please keep us in mind as the holidays start approaching. And you might be like Justin's mom, and you finish up your Christmas shopping by the first week of September.
Oh my gosh, I know. She finishes all her shopping. Like,
so if you guys are like that, before. Please keep us in mind when you do any online purchasing through Amazon. That'd be really amazing. Your mom is hilarious.
She's funny like that, isn't she?
You know what I love about her?
What?
Like if you decide you want something closer to Christmas and she'll ask you, you'll never get it because she's already done. She's just wondering if anything new has come up. But you know that it has to be next year's because...
It'll be next year.
She's done when September rolls around.
So if you guys can support us through Amazon, that would be great. And also, don't forget to check out our sponsors, too. If you go to our sponsors page, it's on the right-hand side of our website. You can click and check out who our sponsors are for this episode, which was the Live On Labs and the SNC, two amazing products. But one thing I do would love for you guys to do, if you guys can't support us in any financial ways that we just talked about, if you guys could, it really does mean a lot, if you guys could give us a review on iTunes and share our show on Facebook. Those are two things that you guys could do that would be incredibly helpful. So pick any show that you like from us and share it with your Facebook or Twitter friends. We'd greatly appreciate that. That doesn't cost anything. It's totally free. And the other thing that would be amazing if... I know a lot of people listen while they're driving or they're walking or running or something. But if you could remember to go back to iTunes when you go back home and get on iTunes, sign into iTunes on the application, on the program, search for Extreme Health Radio in the podcasts, and make sure that you're going to our ones because Natural News has a version of Extreme Health Radio. Make sure it's just Extreme Health Radio. And leave us a review and a rating, and that would be really, really helpful if you guys can't support us in any other way. But I know what it's like listening to podcasts myself. I listen to them, and I think, oh, other people will do that, and you know, it'll be okay because other people will do it and things like that. But if you really could, that would be super helpful. It really does. Every last person that does that will help us. So
it's true because everybody, you know, if everybody thinks everybody else is doing it, nobody will do it.
That's kind of what happens.
I know.
And so that's why I kind of, you know, ask people to do it and just pretend like there's no one else listening and help us out that way.
We'd so appreciate it, you guys.
Yes. Because all of our shows are free. So make sure to do all those things if you can. That would be great, really grateful. And pass our show on to your friends if you enjoyed it. And that's about it, right?
I think that's a wrap.
That's a wrap. I love it. All right, everybody. Thank you so much for listening. And
we will catch you guys on the next episode.
Hey, everybody. This is Josie, Justin's mom. Don't tell him, but I know he would absolutely be really happy if you would sign up to his free weekly newsletter. And don't forget to share this with all your friends. This is the Buzzing Bumblebee signing off.
That was so good.
That's where we get the bumble.
Oh my gosh.
Thank you for listening to this episode.
It's time to go for now, but our mission does not end with this show.
Justin and Kate will be back with another interview packed full of ideas, discoveries, and unique ways to regain your health.
Head on over to extremehealthradio.com/subscribe and instantly download our free gift too that contains cutting-edge strategies to start making healthy lifestyle changes today.
No material on this blog is intended to suggest that you should not seek professional medical care. Always work with qualified medical professionals, even if you educate yourself in the field of live food, nutrition, and alternative medicine. I'm not a doctor, nor am I offering readers medical advice of any kind. None of the information offered here should be interpreted as a diagnosis of any disease, nor an attempt to treat or prevent any disease or condition.